You know, hair loss is a common side effect of cancer treatment. They can have many patients feeling self-conscious and uncomfortable.
A new treatment is helping many patients keep at least some of their hair throughout chemotherapy. Megan McGrath has our report.
I was diagnosed in August of this year, and it was shocking.
After her breast cancer diagnosis, Amy Farage Feo had to explain her illness to her young son. She didn't use the word cancer.
And then when I did share with him that I was going to have to undergo some medicine and I was going to be losing my hair, that's when it really registered with him. And he said back to me, do you have cancer?
Hair loss is one of the many unpleasant side effects of chemotherapy, one that signals to other people that you're sick. But scalp cooling technology is sparing some patients like Farage Feo from that experience. Her hair is thinner, but it's still there.
It does feel good. Feels good to run my hands through it.
How does that feel?
Good, nice and tight.
Okay.
Patients wear a tight cap. A machine pumps in refrigerated coolant, and the cold temperature constricts the blood vessels in the scalp, so less chemo reaches the hair follicles.
Amazingly, you know, that can save your hair.
Dr. Young Lee is an oncologist and a believer in scalp cooling technology.
Constricting those blood vessels on your scalp can save more than 50% of your hair in about 70% of patients.
Patty Heisner is on a chemo regimen where scalp cooling is typically less effective. She's in a trial for a wrap-style cap and is optimistic. These photos were taken after 5 chemo treatments. While you can see some thinning, especially at the top of her head, she's happy with the results so far.
My hair is very thick normally, so it's definitely thinned, but it's thinned all over. So it's not patchy or, in clumps coming out. It's just thinner.
Getting insurance coverage can be tricky. Most patients have to come out of pocket, which can cost over $1,000 or more. But Medicare just approved coverage starting January 1st, and Dr. Lee hopes more private insurers will follow suit. Megan McGrath, News 4.